Huge news from Microsoft and potential release of the Xbox consoles being announced in E3 2019, along with Halo Infinite and how that game could potentially have some RPG elements moving forward. Stay tuned throughout the video to get all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you some news information again on the channel here. If you like these news information videos, please make sure to tap that like button as it greatly helps out the video and channel. Leave a comment down below what your thoughts are on the video as well. And if you're new to the channel, want to stay up to date with anything Xbox or Halo related, make sure to tap subscribe with the bell. We all know sub boxes can be kind of weird at times. Let's get right into the video here. We have two information leaks that recently just happened involving Xbox and Halo. We have a French website called Joe Video, if I believe I pronounced it correctly. I'm not really brushed up on my French too much, but they recently came out with a breaking news update. They sound very confident about how the next generation of consoles for this Xbox Scarlett project is going to be coming out and being announced at E3 this year. So I'm sure you probably heard some names like Scarlett, Lockhart, Anaconda kind of getting thrown around for code names for the next Xboxes being released, but what does this all mean? Well, Scarlett is the Xbox Scarlett family. It kind of encompasses the next generation. That's the name that they're using for the code name. And they have one Xbox that's called Xbox Lockhart, which is kind of a lower end Xbox. And you have Xbox Anaconda, which is going to be more of a higher end Xbox. Kind of think of it like the basic level Xbox One. And then they're also going to be releasing alongside of that an Xbox One X for the next generation, essentially. Now, reading more into it, they seem to be rather confident about some of these details about how they're saying that Lockhart is going to be a lower end Xbox for people to get more entry level kind of thing. But the thing is that they're going to be dispensing the Blu-ray player, so I guess there might not be even a disc drive for this Xbox to kind of help lower down the costs, which to me at this point seems about fair. Personally, I like to collect my physical game copies because I like having a bit of a collection. But with the digital distribution being such a more popular option nowadays, that it's totally understandable to not even have the disc tray with the Xbox. But obviously, some people might be a little upset with that, and that's why they have the Xbox Anaconda, which will come with a disc tray and much higher specs. So let's get right into those specs right here. Now, the Lockhart will come with 8-core processing unit with 16 Zen threads. For the GPU, we have a custom 4 teraflop graphics card, so it's kind of hard to judge it compared to like an Nvidia or anything because it's their own custom thing, but you know, hopefully they make that work. With 12 gigabytes of DDR6 RAM and also a 1 terabyte storage as well. Then we compare that to the Anaconda, it's gonna be the same CPU but with a 12 teraflop GPU and 16 gigabytes of DDR6 RAM and also 1 terabyte. So basically you get quite a bit better graphics card, 3 times more powerful, as well as a bit more RAM so you can run more programs while you're playing your games or watching your videos or anything like that as well. Hey guys, wardrobe change, I know, but I figured I also want to add this part of the video. It's kind of comparing the current Xbox specs to the new ones potentially being for the Lockhart and Anaconda, so you kind of get some comparisons here. So I'm going to compare the Xbox One X, which is like the flagship console right here. For a comparison, the CPU runs at 2.3 gigahertz with a 6 teraflop GPU. Now I say we compare that to the current specs right now, that means that the CPU will probably actually generally stay close to the same. Obviously it's gonna be a little bit better, but not a huge jump in CPU usage. But GPU usage is where you're really gonna see a big jump when it comes to the Lockhart. The cheaper version is gonna feature 4 teraflops of memory, so actually a little bit less than the Xbox One X. But the Anaconda, the higher end console, is gonna be featuring 12, so literally double the amount as GPU graphical power in that console compared to the Xbox One X. And for also comparison as well, that the original Xbox One currently has 1.3 teraflops. So if you're going from a regular Xbox to a Lockhart, that's definitely still gonna be an upgrade for you. It's a little bit of a, it's like a nice little bump. A little like, oh, here you go. Here's a little nice little bump for your performance. If you're gonna go from original Xbox to potentially what the Anaconda has to offer, that's literally like almost 10 times the better performance on that console than your current Xbox One. Now this is where we kind of get into the Halo information part of this video here, and they state that Halo Infinite is kind of scheduled to release along with this Xbox Scarlett family and 2020, which is kind of seems about right when it comes to the release date of the next Halo game. For one, 343 has been very tight-lipped when it comes to information, so you know that they're not willing to commit to anything publicly about this game, so you know that's very much in deep development at this point. I even talked to some 343 developers as well, and they say, yeah, we have a lot of work ahead of us. This would be pretty huge for Halo, as it would be the first time since Halo Combat Evolved, the very first Halo back in 2001, where Halo, basically the flagship title of Xbox, was a launch title for the console, which seems kind of weird to hear that, you know? It's been almost 18 years since the release of the first Halo, but this could be a chance for the Halo Infinite to be the first time in a long time, over a decade, almost two decades really, of the next Halo game being released alongside a new console, so a huge selling point right there for both console and game. But they do also state that the game will be coming out on the Xbox One, as well as we can assume that everyone's going to be willing to jump onto the next console generation as soon as possible. Now this also kind of just confirms with me that 2020 release date, as we know that the consoles most likely are being released in 2020. From what it looks like, Halo Infinite has been kind of just more rumored to be a 2020 release. As well, we have the TV show, which has been announced to be released in the fall of 2020 as well. So looking for huge things for Xbox and Halo come around the fall of 2020. And do have recent information that the production of the Halo TV series will begin very, very soon. We have all these different things kind of coming to, boom, fall 2020. Looking to be a pretty big year for Halo and Xbox. Oh wait, we're not done with the Halo news for sure. Actually, the website Thurrott, I believe that's how you pronounce it, they recently came out with a little bit of an information leak as well, which these guys did also kind of leak out the name of Halo Infinite a little bit before, like I think the day before we had Halo actually announced. They called it Halo Infinity, so we're pretty close on the title right there. And after reading them again, the website that they released about the information, you know, they didn't have everything correct, but it was pretty much spot on for having no official information. Not only will Halo have brand new hardware, a brand new engine, but they're also looking to have a brand new story type kind of telling with this game, have it be more of an RPG-like elements into the game, rather have it be a like on-rails campaign curated experience, possibly. And so then this thing would be kind of interesting to see how they would add RPG elements into Halo Infinite. It all kind of depends how you do it though. I think the main thing, if you're going to have an RPG element, which I think would kind of lend itself to a game, would be much more to a game as a service platform, which they're looking to do with Halo Infinite, as you can kind of continually add in new content with a game elements like that. Can you continually level up your character every time every new expansion comes out, you have a new way to increase your single player experience kind of thing. So it would make kind of sense to have a RPG game with a live service platform that they have for Halo Infinite. And so it'd be kind of interesting how they do this. But I think the main thing though with this RPG kind of game is to make sure the story is good. If you guys don't remember or haven't played Halo 5, it really wasn't that good of a story, which kind of helps, which makes it kind of difficult to really get yourself into the game when the game itself really isn't bringing you in. Yeah, the gameplay I'm sure is going to be fantastic. They could probably do some solid, you know, basic level RPG elements. But ultimately, it's about the story, and that's what makes these games rememberable. And if you don't have a good story, it's hard to get people invested into a long-term game like an RPG, which generally tend to last about 40 hours or so in game time. Now, these are all just rumors, obviously, and we're pretty early on E3 here. E3 is not happening until June, so we're 4 months ahead on the information. But these are just continuous rumors that we've been hearing, and now they've almost been kind of like confirmed rumors, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense when you think about it, but we keep on hearing about 2020 being a big year for Xbox and Halo. Now what do I think about these news updates? I think that I'm not quite sure about the dual console idea when it comes to Xbox. I feel like consumers on a very basic level will kind of find that confusing about which one is the better console really, and really it's only just a little bit better quite a bit better graphics card with the higher end one, though we've seen that over time, you know, Xbox released the original Xbox, the X1S, and then the Xbox One X. So the thing is that those were all released individually over a spread of time. Now what they're kind of doing is releasing a basic level Xbox and an Xbox One X-like system together at the same time. I don't know if that would be kind of conflicting to their sales, or let's see which one sells more or something like that. I have a feeling probably the lower end will probably sell better. They do mention that the Xbox Anaconda would probably run for about $500, much like how the Xbox One X did as well. So if you're gonna have no disk drive and have it basically just be a digital download platform for the lower end Xbox, if you kind of sell it with a much smaller size to the console as well, I think it would kind of help really sell that product a lot more than the higher end one. When it comes to me, I'm definitely gonna be buying the higher end one because I love Halo. We do streams, we do Halo content on this channel. We gotta do the best quality possible, which will probably involve getting the higher end Xbox for Halo Infinite. So I do feel we'll have a lot more information on E3 this year when it comes to the next generation of consoles, when it comes to Xbox, and a lot more information when it comes to Halo Infinite. And we know 343 has been very tight-lipped right now when it comes to news. I'm pretty sure once E3 comes around, we'll be just swimming in that Halo Infinite news, just waiting in that pool and be like, yeah, this is pretty nice right here. I like this. Anyways, guys, that's gonna do me for the video right now. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below with your thoughts on the Xbox Scarlett family with the Lockhart and Anaconda, as well as the Halo Infinite news, maybe possibly being an RPG influenced game. Possibly. And if you're new to the channel and want to stay up to date with anything Halo related or Xbox related, make sure to tap subscribe with the bell. And if you missed any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right now. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.